We start with March 1st, when the state of Florida announced its first two cases. One, a woman from Tampa who had traveled to Italy, and a Manatee County man with no travel history. The next day, the Florida Department of Health asked people not to travel to certain countries. On March 5th, Florida had its first two official coronavirus deaths in Santa Rosa and Lee counties. Many of us remember the increasing cases on cruise ships like the Regal Princess, which on March 8th was ordered to remain offshore of South Florida with 21 people on board with the virus. On that same day, Publix started limiting the items customers could buy as the essential supply hoarding got out of control. Over the next week, Governor DeSantis declared a state of emergency to get extra funding and resources. Limits were put on nursing home visits, and state universities were told they'd be going to virtual learning after spring break. All public school students were told to take an extra week off after their spring break, which we now know turned into finishing the year virtually. In what would become a continuous blow to the state's economy and jobs, Disney and Universal were shut down on March 15th. At this point, the Florida Department of Health confirms there were 216 total COVID-19 cases and 7 total deaths. The governor then orders bars and nightclubs to shut down. 6 days later, March 23rd, travel restrictions were in place for anyone coming to Florida from the Northeast. It meant 14 days of quarantine, and our numbers of cases in Florida jumped up to more than 1,200. Pinellas County marked its first COVID death on March 24th. By March 26th, Hillsborough and Pinellas counties had all issued orders telling people to stay home. On April 1st, the entire state was in lockdown after an order from the governor. Now, with close to 8,000 confirmed cases in the state and 101 deaths.